What? These nerves are why I couldn't sleep at night. These sirens couldn't be any louder, for I was covered in numbers of dreams, along with an annoying ringing in my ears that not even the biggest number of sheep could make disappear. And these voices who I couldn't and wouldn't pay any mind to kept creeping up on me, especially those who had screamed no to me, because in their minds I was fragile and weak. If only they knew what it reinforced this skin. If only they knew what it feels like to sit in piercing darkness with sore eyes, trying to find the smallest glimpse of light. Then they would know what it feels like to bump into spears of hate, of paranoia, of phobias, to repeatedly step upon broken mirrors and burning embers of past confrontations, and feel your body weaken and your hands hurt to the bones as you release punches to stone walls. That's how I feel as I sit silenced in my own house full of strangers. I feel alone. So I write poems, because nothing is as personal and comforting as a pen and paper and an open vein, expressing my emotions in the only way I could, because I feel alone. And there are times when I would reopen scars to dig out any screams I can, to leave an echo or a whisper that reminded them that I'm still here, that I'm still strong and willing to move on, that I'm still strong no matter how many nasty phrases are thrown at me, no matter how many nasty phrases my family throws at me. I'm strong. I'm strong, I'm strong. Tonight, I wrap myself up in my beautiful rainbow flag. Tonight, I stand taller than ever. This little speck of dust is moving mountains, making huge dents and paths of progress for future generations, and making past generations proud. I am part of a movement. I am my own movement. You are your own movement. Progress as much as you can. Push your stupid limit out of the way. You are infinite. You are infinite. You are beautiful. Thank you.